Questions unanswered, I don't understand. Could you please explain, sir? I'm in a phase, I believe I can change in exchange for an explanation. Estimation, hesitation. Isn't this visible? Dealing with digital, fidgeting through email when the issue is pivotal, critical condition. Not heads in, I'm heading in the wrong direction. Book me a session, let it off my chest. I'll invest in a cannon just so I can blow with my flow as my right hand man. With ash spitting, I'm mad different, just as Jigga. He listened and witnessed the birth of a star. Emerging and surging his way up to the top of the charts. I'll sing along.
As I'm listening, I'm saying, you know, it ain't a joke.
There's some bars up in there. And like I said, like when I was growing up and when I was writing, it was almost more about poetry. Like I have joints that like are about child obesity. Like there's glimpses of, it's interesting because no people are basing their opinions off of me of out of college. Like they have no idea. Like there's some shit like the joint that I rapped at Key Club about child obesity, and Just Listen was kind of into that a little bit. You know, I'm here for the fathers and mothers, sisters and brothers, for the guilty, the innocent citizens and the immigrants, and talking about like, you know, how racial barriers and everything should need to be, you know, I understand the history and everything behind it, but at 2010, in 95, if we would have been talking about 2010, we would have been like, oh, flying cars and fucking teleporting. And here we are still facing the same fucking struggles that we were facing in 85. So it's going to be so important as a community in hip hop that I think if hip hop can do it, we're going to be able to do it on a global scale, on a global level. And right now, it's just something that as humans, it's holding us back, is because we're basing our opinions off people based off of just stereotypes. And I'm not saying that, you know, there's obviously a naivety to it from my perspective, just because, you know, coming where I'm coming from, there's some very real shit. I had a buddy who was telling me about photography, and he was like, he was like with 2 weeks with a crackhead, and going through that shit, and he was like, guns, drugs, all this, and when you experience that for your life, you realize that none of this shit is real, and that's actually for sure.
I got a couple questions, like, you know, A, where did this influence or inspiration come from, you know, the rap?
Dude, it's been around for a minute. I mean, Black Star, The Roots, you know, Pharoah Monch, there have been uplifting and enlightening rappers since the beginning of hip hop music. It just got tainted by money. It just got tainted by greed and ego. And you see, even, I mean, everyone saw that the Kanye South Park shit.
Oh God!
Everybody saw that shit, but that's what happens when you can't laugh at your own joke and you let your ego get the best of you. And that, the thing is, I was talking to my buddy the other day about egos and how it's dangerous, because then you start to cut out the people who are 100 with you, because you let your ego win. So now you're surrounding yourself with nothing but yes men. And that's what happens. So you have to be, that's why I was talking about knowledge of self. It's so important for people to spend time with themselves. And I'm not talking about masturbating. I'm talking about sitting down and being like, what do I want to accomplish? What do I want out of this life? Because you see it all the time in the verbs, man. These people end up 50, like there's, I forget who the author was or whatever, they're talking about everybody in the suburbs has a hidden secret and is miserable. And on some real shit, there's 50-year-olds that are just like, where the fuck did my life go? Because not once did they ask, what am I trying to do? What am I trying to accomplish? What do I want out of this life?
Do you feel you have to be more retrospective since you don't have that like typical urban rap background that most people do have when they do rap and that they do like pull off of?
I absolutely have to come here for a purpose. I can't just be up here talking about how great I am and shit like what I have. Like no one would be like, I'm like, fucking get out of here. So for me, it's super important for me to bring something to the table. And it's gotta be something different, you know what I mean? You've got several brownies and cupcakes, and there's a lot of desserts in the desserts, right? I'm like, oh, whatever, well, I'll bring a parfait. You know what I mean? People might not eat it, but they're gonna be like, damn, I'm gonna bring another parfait. I mean, that's really what it comes down to, is just bringing something different. I can't put on a front. It would be so obvious. Like, look at me. Right? And we'll just be like, all right, he's lying. So for me, it was just like, this is who I am. Speaking with honesty and integrity was the most important thing for me. This is the next single, and everyone obviously is like, yo, la-di-da, she don't want a man. There's different options for singles, but to me, it kind of made the most sense in the whole storyboard that since college did its thing. Be By Myself with CeeLo, we just shot a video with him. And this is kind of about, I mean, I've had a couple dudes be like, this is my anthem, because it's kind of a response to Beyonce's single Ladies, where it's just like, oh, if you like it, then you should have put a ring. I was like, oh, whatever, I'm 23, and I'm not trying to put a ring on anything right now. So that's really what it's about, just kind of embracing this lifestyle of being on the road and not being able to be in a relationship.
Yeah. No rings.
You kind of just go about it, and you know, you don't really think about it. And then when CeeLo comes back singing a hook that you wrote, you're like, oh shit, that's wild. So when that happened, that was very much a special moment for me. Number six, She Don't Want a Man. That was an anthem for the kind of single dudes. And with Ladies, I have two older sisters, so I kind of have like, I want to be a douchebag so bad, but I can't, like, they're programmed. So She Don't Want a Man is kind of like reality of how it really goes down. I mean, I know that girls kind of like to dance and boogie, and every time that I've gone to the club, I always get turned down. Like, I don't have sex on the dance floor like people were talking about in these songs. Like, oh, she had her titties in my face and shit. I'm like, I go up on the dance floor, and they're like, get the fuck away from me. I'm dancing my girl. So I got a hold of Carrie, who I met down in Atlanta, and I wrote this song called She Don't Want a Man, which is essentially about, you know, girls being at the club and they just want to dance. So. She don't want a man. Feeling sexy.